Well, hi there, food friends. It's Kevin.
Good morning. I'm Ralph, behind the camera.
And yes, good morning. And what I'm doing, Ralph, is I'm melting what was 2 tablespoons of butter into 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Okay?
To make an old favorite.
So, because what we're going to do is we're going to saute up a little bit of vegetables, because this morning we're making an Italian frittata.
Yeah, we were going to just have breakfast, and this was something I said, why don't we just film it and show folks what you put into it? So we're going to make a frittata.
Yeah, we're going to make a frittata. And if frittatas are not a complicated dish, they're a great way to, I think of them as like a baked omelet. They're a great way to, and they're a great way to use up leftover ingredients.
Which is what we're kind of doing.
Exactly what we're doing. So I've got a small, medium onion here that I've diced up, so we're going to put that in there. And then we had some green pepper from the farmer's market that we didn't use the whole thing. So this is about a half of a green pepper. You could use more. This is the beautiful thing about frittatas or omelets, is that it really gives you that opportunity to use up things that you might have left over.
And you can get creative.
Exactly.
Anything goes.
Now, we got some Italian sausage here. Now, this is already cooked. Sliced it up. We're going to put that in. It's kind of sweet, hot. I mean, it's got a little heat to it. It's got the fennel. Now, if you had another kind of, you could use regular breakfast pork sausage. You could use kielbasa. You could use
chorizo
if you want. If you wanted to take this Mexican, and then you could put more Mexican, you know, you could put onions and
tomatoes,
exactly,
cumin,
and use more Mexican spices. But this is what we have, so this is what we're going to do. So,
is it good to have a cast iron skillet, or could you do it in anything?
You could. You need something that is oven safe.
Oh, right, because it's going to go into the
oven. So we're going to start it on top of the stove. I've got the oven preheated to 350 degrees. So you could use any kind of shallow pan that would work. This is just what we have, so this is what I'm using.
All right, so you're sweating the onion
peppers
and peppers.
The onions. Okay, now I'm
garlic's
sure you,
also a good start. Sometimes you could put garlic in there.
You could put garlic in, and so in a minute, I'm going to put in, I got a couple of Italian sausage links that I'm going to put in. I'm going to put in some sliced up stuffed green olives. That'll give us a little salty. I've got cheese that's going to go on the top. Now, I've got 6 eggs here.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to add, when I make scrambled eggs or I beat eggs for omelets or frittatas, I like to add maybe, for 6 eggs, I might want to add a tablespoon or 2 of water.
Okay, cold water, warm water, doesn't matter?
Doesn't matter. I'm going to put some little nice salt and pepper here. And also, I'm going to put in, because we are staying with sort of an Italian kind of theme, I'll beat into, I got a little bit, probably a half a teaspoon here of
oregano?
Italian seasoning. So it's basil, oregano, and that'll just kind of give us a little bit more of that flavor.
Oh, and you know, we still have some herbs left over in the herb garden. Maybe we can snip off some fresh basil to top it at the end.
Oh, it might make a nice garnish. I'm going to beat these eggs here and have them ready.
Okay.
So, this is also nice if you have a big crowd and you don't want to make, you know, four or five omelets and whatever, and you could all, of course, do a big batch of scrambled eggs, but this is a nice way to...
I think I heard you say that frittata is almost like a quiche without a
crust. That's kind of, I think, that's how I kind of see it. All right, these are doing really nice here. You want them, we don't want them brown, we just want them soft and kind of translucent. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take our Italian sausage and I'm going to throw that in the mix. Because again, this the sausage has been cooked already, but we want it kind of warm through.
Yeah,
maybe put a little brown on
it. Right, I was going to say give it a little color.
So let's put that in there. All right, we're going to let the sausage get brown, let those vegetables keep cooking.
So that'll take a few.
Take a few minutes. I'm going to, it looks like we got our eggs good here. I'm going to give this another little whip, and we'll be back and get our frittata together.
Okay, so we're starting to smell the sausage.
Yes.
Right? The fennel.
Yes, those flavors, the spices that make Italian sausage so yummy.
So, what I'm going to do now is we're going to sprinkle in these chopped olives here. Get that in there.
That's something you want to add more towards the end because they stay a little crunchy?
Yeah, we don't need the olives to cook per se.
Yeah.
Okay, so now, though, what we're going to do is we're going to take our eggs. I'm going to turn our heat down a little bit. I'm going to take our six beaten eggs here, and we're going to put these over in the pan. Okay, now, here's what we want to do, Ralph. We want that to sort of set, okay?
Kind of firm up a bit?
Firm up a little bit. So we kind of want to get this to sort of set. Now, if we were making an omelet, you know, we'd kind of be doing the same thing. We'd want the egg to set, and then we would, you know, at some point kind of flip it over. Of course, we're not flipping this. So what we want to do is we want to kind of just get the eggs to set.
And the reason you turned the heat down a bit was so because eggs do burn quickly, so you want to make sure not to burn it. So you want it to the heat to do its thing in terms of firming it up and not overdo it.
Now, remember, too, there's stuff on the bottom of the pan, okay? Sort of between the eggs and the bottom of the pan, too. We've got all those peppers and onions. But we're going to just kind of keep this. This will take about 3 or 4 minutes.
How firm does it need to get before you pop it in the oven for baking?
You see, I'm looking at the sides.
Oh, the edges.
Yeah.
So when that starts to...
And when we have... See how it's moving around? We want a little less of that.
A little less of that fluidity.
So I'm going to just kind of, again, let the heat of the skillet start to firm the eggs up a little bit. And then we're going to put it on into... we'll top it with our cheese, and then we're going to put it into our 350-degree oven, for probably about 20 minutes. Hey, Ralph.
Oh, yeah.
Can you see? You can see how the egg is setting. You see that?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the wetness is reduced a bit. It's not as...
Right. There's still, you still got the liquid on the top,
but it's not going crazy like it was before.
No. And you can see, especially, here... around, you can see this thing setting. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to top it with cheese.
Lots of cheese.
I had about maybe a half a cup of cheese, and Ralph said, that's not enough cheese.
I just said, let's just use the whole bag.
Use the rest of that whole bag. So
make it cheesy.
We're doing that. So this is probably a cup and a half of cheese, which is fine. We happen to have this, again, we're using up leftovers here, so this is a sharp cheddar cheese. Of course, since this is an Italian recipe, if we really were going to do it on purpose, we'd have used a mozzarella or something like that, but that's not what we had on hand. So, again, you know what, folks? We always say, what the fun part about cooking is how creative you can be.
Yeah.
All right, so now I'm just going to take this. And we're
going to
put it in here. See in about 15, 20 minutes. Okay, we'll keep an eye on it. We want it just nice and golden brown on the top. So, frittata time right here on Cavalcade of Food. Okay, it's been 20 minutes. And... you see it in there?
Yeah, that cheese is really bubbling, and it smells, I was saying to Kevin, it smells like a pizza.
Look at that.
Nice.
Pretty, huh? And,
You have to let it cool for a while?
We're going to give it a minute to sort of just set, and,
You took my idea of getting some
fresh.
I took
your idea. I went out, this is really the last of the basil from the herb garden. So you know what? We're just going to sprinkle this on the top, pretty it up a little bit. And you can see how, Ralph, I don't know if you can get in here, but you can see how you got kind of a nice little
brown
around the edge. And we're just going to let it calm down, okay? And maybe let it rest for about
no more than 5 minutes. And then we're going to slice into it, mm. and we'll have our breakfast. So, you know, this is also a great brunch dish.
Yes.
You know, if you're having people over for brunch. You know, we're going to cut this like a pie. You can cut it any way you want, but you can cut it like a pie. And, you know, you could easily get 8 servings out of here.
Oh, I see what you're doing there.
Okay, this, and you see, I don't know if you can see, as it's cooled off, it
shrinks in a bit?
Yeah, it's kind of like a cake. When you cool a cake, it kind of pulls away from the edges a little bit. Same thing here, okay? And like a souffle, when a souffle starts to cool, it deflates. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just put a slice like so. Okay? You with me?
Yeah, you're making like a, just like a pie slice, like a triangle, okay?
I'm actually using a get under here. There it is. Mm. So, now, let's just, the underside. See that nice crust?
Yeah.
And then you've got a couple pieces of sausage there, and looks like green pepper, and some couple of onions.
And it's holding together pretty well. Mm. Come out good?
Delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm.
So there you go.
There you are. So, you know, a real easy breakfast, and
you could serve a crowd, you could serve a couple of people,
you could serve a crowd, could serve Ralph and I.
Same difference.
But this is a great way, again, to use up things you might have left over in the fridge or in the pantry. Way to really be creative with your cooking. You can take this in a million different directions. Our friend the frittata. So,
you know what I was thinking too? You could put like a tomato sauce on top of it too, like kind of in a nice design to make it look kind of fun.
And that would even take it to another
tomato-y,
Italian level. You're right. But so, yeah.
Must have not got a lot of frittata. We were sweating to the oldies on this one, and we had a lot of fun making this episode. Yeah.
Thanks for being part of this one. We had a good time. Hope you did too. And you know what? See you next time on Cavalcade
of Food.
Bye.